West Virginia. The Ridge Mountain, Shenandoah River. Life is older than the trees. Younger than the mountains. Blowing like a breeze. Country roads, take me home to the place.
Good morning, everyone. At least the sun's out and it's not raining, so that's quite nice. My name is Vanessa Rankin and I'm a civil celebrant, and it is my privilege to conduct this service this morning for Lorna Esther Martin and stand here with you as you mourn the loss of a very special person in your life. Due to COVID and this difficult time when we need the support of our loved ones and extended family, we're being asked to physically and socially isolate. The loss of a loved one continues to unite us mentally and emotionally, and with those that are unable to be here in person, but are here in spirit, holding you in their hearts, and while only you, the immediate family, are here, you are being supported from afar through the wonders of live streaming. And I welcome those people watching and thank them for joining us today. And I do hope that Lorna's daughter Sharon in America and her family are able to join us today. We express our sympathy to Lorna's family, her children, Dorothy, John, Gary and Sharon, and their partners, Karen, Deb, Greg and Michael. We also think today of her 8 grandchildren, Rodney, Melissa, Steve, Cassandra, Brendan, Kayla, Olivia, and Ryan, and Ryan. Lorna was also a loving great-grandmother to Nathan, Talia, Max, Harriet, Zoe, and Mason. So our thoughts are with you all today. We've come together to honour, commemorate and give thanks for the life of Lorna, and today we will mourn her leaving us, honour her life and death, and reverently farewell her body and comfort each other. Today is a time to share thoughts and memories of Lorna and to provide some consolation to her family and friends who will miss her greatly. When someone who is very much loved dies, their death causes sorrow and grief, as they are now no longer part of your everyday life. We do know that death is the natural order of things, just as night follows day. Yet we know it's hard to face death, and as it represents the loss of someone we loved and also played a unique part in our lives. You are sharing your grief as you mourn Lorna, and I hope you can derive some comfort from this as you remember her and the wonderful memories you have of her, some of which you hold in common, but others for the love you had for Lorna. Today you recall the experiences and the relationship you shared with Lorna. As we celebrate her life, you can take satisfaction that Lorna was and still is a part of your lives. Her influence will endure and continue in the love that flows from her character and deed. Our lives are richer for having had her in our life. Lorna has been a strength to you all, an inspiration. She has been very good company, and she has enriched our lives by giving us love and friendship. And we have derived mutual fulfillment from this, giving meaning and value to life. I met with the family the other day, and they told me that Lorna was born in Griffith on the 23rd of July, 1941. She was one of four children. Her early life was spent at Corowa, where she trained as a hairdresser, but she didn't actually get a job in that career. Cafe when a young man came in and asked for an ice cream. As she bent over to serve him, this particular person got more than a good look at her and decided he liked what he saw, and very soon afterwards they struck up a relationship. And yes, you've guessed it, it was Les, and they were happily married in Corowa in 1959. That's one way of meeting somebody, isn't it? Bit cold for ice creams today though. They lived in Corowa for a while, and before then, after that, they moved to Cobram, where the family grew, and along came Dorothy, John, Gary and Sharon. Lorna worked hard all her life. She was a very capable person, and she could turn her hand to most jobs. Lorna worked at Cornish's Orchard in the packing shed, and also worked at the Cobram Bakery. She was from the old school, working hard for what she wanted for her family. Nothing was ever a problem for her. She got on the task with providing and caring for her family and for others. Her motto was, if you want something, you work hard for it. John said, Mum wore the pants in the family as she managed and helped all the family when they needed something. She was there to guide them and give them advice. Lorna was the person to get things done. Lorna struggled with her health for most of her life, but she continued to fight on and continue working. Unfortunately, Les died suddenly from a heart attack, which left Lorna to live on alone. This was a difficult time for her. As her health deteriorated, Lorna eventually moved in and lived with Dorothy and Greg, who looked after her. Dorothy said that Mum was a very good cook, and when she first came to live with them, she was always telling Greg to get out of the bloody way, as you don't know what you're doing. But she did say that Greg's lemon and jam tarts were pretty good. Dorothy said that her mother was a very hard worker. She never complained about anything until the day when she was working at Cornish's and a truck driver put a dead snake under the cushion in her car and left it there for 8 hours in the heat. When Mum opened the car door, the stench was unbearable. She let out a very loud scream and ran while everyone was laughing and watching. She never spoke to them again for several months after that, saying, not bloody funny. I don't think it would be either, would it? Another memory from Dorothy was that Mum loved rock and roll dancing. And every Friday night when she finished her shift working at the pub in Corowa, she would change into her rock and roll dress, go out the front and dance on the flat top trailer, and dance the night away, really enjoying herself. John told me that Mum was the best mum in the world, and she went above and beyond to help her family. When he was 15 and just started work, for years for Mother's Day, she bought him work boots. John said Mum was the heart, soul and rock of our family. John also said all the grandchildren were loved equally by Mum. And I quote from John, my mum, sent from heaven to be my mum, going back home now, the job is done. Gary told me that his mum was honest, loving, caring, but she could be hard on us when needed. She always put others before her own needs. She wasn't afraid to get outside and get her hands dirty. No task was too hard. The only job she would leave Dad to do was work on the car. Gary says Mum was a great cook and she made the best apple pies and that she loved all her grandkids and her kids the same. Now, I got an email from Sharon, which I'd like to share with you, and thanks, Sharon. Mum, you were never just my mum. You were my walking partner, my sounding board, my advisor, my shoulder to cry on, my best friend. You were my rock. You never liked to have any attention focused on you, always happy to just blend into the background. You were a true nurturer by nature, always looking after others, whether it was sewing curtains, doing someone's ironing, driving friends around, or secret Christmas shopping for others. But you never wanted or expected anything in return. In fact, I think you were probably more embarrassed if anyone made a fuss over you. Sitting down with you and having a cuppa, a chat, and a bit of banter was enough to make your day. I remember you would drive to Shepparton to do a big grocery shop every fortnight, and I would race home from school on those days, as there would be always something small waiting for me at the end of the bed. It may have been as simple as a pair of socks, but it was always there. We would walk around Cobram for hours on end, sticky nosing at houses, and just talking constantly about nothing in particular. If we couldn't walk due to the weather or your health, then we'd drive around instead. Or we'd sit together and watch Elvis Presley or Bruce Lee movies. Mum, you taught me to cook, sew, garden, and to work hard and have a good work ethic for which I will always be grateful. We had nicknames for each other, which stuck for years. You called me Joy, my middle name, which I don't understand. So in return, I would shorten your middle name and call you Ez. We weren't much into holidays, although I did manage to get you on the Spirit of Tasmania for a long weekend once, and several weekends away in Bright. As much as you enjoyed it, I know home was where you were the happiest. The simple things like going out for a cuppa or lunch was enough for you. You were always there for me no matter what, always running to Tatura to help look after the kids when they were babies, even just to sit in the car with them so I could run in and out of shops. You never left until the house was spotless, the washing and ironing up to date, the weeds were pulled, and a casserole for dinner was waiting in the fridge. I wish I could have been there for just one more cuddle. No more aches and pains or sleepless nights now, Mum. Rest peacefully and give my love to Dad. I love you and miss you, Ez. Joy. So thanks, Sharon. Part of the master plan, a step on the road to home. When you are lonely and sick of heart, go to the friends we know and bury your sorrow in doing good deeds. Miss me, but let me go. We now gently and reverently commit the body of our much loved Lorna Ez Martin to its natural elements, from which all life comes and from which all life in the end returns, where she will rest forever with her loving husband, Les. To love someone is to risk the pain of parting. Not to love is never to have lived. We rejoice that Lorna lived. We took delight in her friendship. We treasure that she shared in our life. We cherish and love her. With love, we leave her in peace. With respect, we bid her farewell. Until we meet again, rest in peace. On behalf of Lorna's family, I thank you all for coming here today and sharing in this celebration of her life. And thank you to all the family and friends that joined live streaming. Our thoughts are all with you too. May Lorna rest in peace. Thank you. So if some of the family would like to come forward and put a flower on the coffin.
Love me tender, love me sweet. Building.